Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD.
Today I'm going to explain about history and objectives of plant breeding. History of plant breeding is divided into four parts. One is pre-Mendelian era, which is before 1900. Another one is Mendelian era, which is from 1900 to 1920. Post-Mendelian era, which is from 1921 to 1950. And the last one is modern era, which is after 1950. First, coming to the pre-Mendelian era, in 1900 BC, first evidence of plant domestication in the hill by Tigris River was found. Agriculture communities exist in Mesopotamia, and even in 700 BC, hand pollination of date palm was observed. In 1676, anther function as a male organ was discovered. In 1717, Fairchild produced the first artificial hybrid popularly known as Fairchild Mule, a cross carnation with Sweet William's variety of Dianthus. In 1761-66, a German scientist demonstrated that the hybrid offspring received trait from both parent and were intermediate in most trait. In 1979, Knight emphasized the practical aspect of hybrid. In 1819, utilized pure line selection to develop a new wheat cultivar that is released in 1824. A new wheat variety was released in 1832. In 1866, Mendel published experiment in plant hybridization, discovered unit factor, that is a gene, segregation of F2, recombination of two or more genes, dominance of one allele over another, formulated the law of inheritance. Hopkins described ear-to-row selection method in the year 1899. Here, the second one is the Mendelian year, where Baston introduced the term allelomorph, homozygote, heterozygote, F1 and F2. In 1902, De Veris from Poland proposed the mutation theory of evolution on his experiment on Oenothera lamarckiana. Baffin from England on his studies on inheritance of studies on disease resistance found that the strip rust resistance was due to single gene. In 1903, Johansson developed the pure line theory of selection. Yule gave the initial idea of multiple factor hypothesis in the year 1906. Bateson introduced the term genetics in the year 1906. In the year 1908, Nesselson gave the explanation of multiple factor hypothesis for gene color of wheat. In the year 1914, Schell introduced the term heterosis. Coming to the post-Mendelian era, in the year 1927, Muller reported artificial mutation in animal by X-ray. In the year 1928, Stadler discovered or described the mutagenic effect of X-ray in barley. In 1929, McClintock first to report the number 10 chromosomes in maize. In 1931, Stern and McClintock provided the cytological proof of crossing over. In 1945, Hull proposed recurrent selection method. कॉमस्टॉक इन 1946 कॉमस्टॉक एट ऑल सजेस्टेड रेसिप्रोकल दैट इज हाफ सिब रिकरेंट सेलेक्शन. मॉडर्न एरा इन 1952 जेनसन फर्स्ट सजेस्टेड द यूज ऑफ मल्टीलाइन्स इन ओट. इन 1953 यानी बोरलॉग फर्स्ट आउटलाइंड द मेथड ऑफ डेवलपिंग मल्टीलाइन्स इन व्हीट. इन 1963 the concept of vertical and horizontal resistance was found out. And in 1964, Borlaug developed the high-yielding dwarf variety of wheat, which resulted in Green Revolution. In 1964, Donald developed the concept of crop ideotype in wheat. In 1978, development of world first rice hybrid, that is cytoplasmic male sterility based for commercial use, was developed in commercial cultivation in China. Then in 1983, development of first transgenic genetically engineered plant of tobacco in USA. And development of first transgenic cotton plant by Monsanto company in USA was developed at 1987. Flavor saver tomato was introduced by Calgene company of California. It was the first commercial grown genetically engineered crop. History of plant breeding in India. The Government of India created Department of Agriculture in the year 1871. The first maize hybrid was released in the year 1961. Indian Central Cotton Community was established in 1921. The Imperial Agricultural Research Institute was established in Pusa, that is Bihar. It was first agricultural research institute in our country. The Imperial Agricultural Research Institute shifted to its present location in New Delhi. In 1957, all Indian coordinated maize improvement project was started with the objective to exploit heterosis. In 1964, first sorghum hybrid, that is CSH1, was released. In 1965, first bajra hybrid was released. In 1991, the first pigeon hybrid was released from ICRISAT, Hyderabad. Some Indian plant breeder. T.S. Venkataramana, he transferred thick stem high sugar content of tropical cane, that is Carum officinarum, officinarum to Indian cane, that is Carum barberi. This process is known as nobilization of sugar cane. B.P. Pal, the first director general of ICAR, he developed some superior disease resistant variety of wheat. M.S. Swaminathan, the father of Green Revolution in India, he developed the high-yielding dwarf variety of wheat. Pushkar Nath, a famous potato breeder, who developed several high-yielding variety of potato. N.G.P. Rao, he is an eminent sorghum breeder and developed the world first hybrid sorghum, that is CSH1. Objectives of plant breeding. Higher productivity. Increased yield has been ultimate aim of the plant breeder. This can be achieved by developing more efficient genotype having great physiological efficiency. Improved quality. Improved quality of agriculture product has contributed to lot of human well-being. The quality character vary from one crop to another. For example, if you take grain size or color, milling, baking, qualities in wheat, all these comes under improved quality. Then disease and insect resistance. Resistance variety offer the cheapest and most convenient method of disease and insect management. In some case, they offer only feasible means of control, example rust in wheat. Fourth objective is varieties for new season. The varieties for new season have been developed by adjusting the growth cycle of the variety to suit better to the available growing season. Traditionally, maize is a kharif crop, but scientists have now able to grow maize throughout the year. Similarly, mung is now grown as a summer crop in addition to the main kharif crop. Modification of agronomic characteristic. Modification of agronomic characteristics such as plant height, tillering, branching, erect or trailing, habit, etc. is often desirable. For example, dwarfness in cereals is generally associated with lodging resistance and fertilizer responsiveness. The change in maturity duration. It permits new crop rotation and often extend the crop area. Development of wheat variety suitable for late planting has permitted rice wheat rotation. This objective is most desirable, especially in those area where multiple crop system has been followed. Photo and thermo insensitivity. The development of photo and thermo insensitive wheat and photo insensitive rice variety has permitted their cultivation in new area. Example, cultivation of wheat in Kerala and West Bengal. Cultivation of rice in Punjab and Himachal Pradesh. Synchronous maturity. Synchronous maturity is highly desirable in crop where several picking are necessary. Example, mung bean, pigeon pea, cotton, etc. Non-shattering characteristic. It would be of great value in crop like mung, castor, soya bean, etc. where shattering is major problem in case of many commercial variety. Determinate growth. Development of variety with determinate growth is desirable in crop like mung, pigeon pea and cotton, etc. Dormancy. Dormancy play a both beneficial and harmful role according to the need of the grower. For example, if we want next crop immediately after harvesting the previous crop, this in such case dormancy is not required. But if we want to store the seed for its future purpose, the period of dormancy is necessary. Elimination of toxic substance. Some crops have toxic substances which must be eliminated to make them safe for consumption. For example, the elimination of erucic acid from brassica oil or gossypol from the seed of cotton is necessary to make them fit for the consumption.
Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.